Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2345. There's weather data in Excel. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, the Wolfram Alpha people talked about hundreds of new things that they're adding to Excel, and weather's not mentioned, but holy smokes, weather is awesome. Let's take a look.
All right, weather. Here's Merritt Island, Florida, and I've converted that to a location, not geography. That's the old one, location, the new Wolfram Alpha type. And I initially came here and I saw that they had something called .weather. And I'm like, whoa, that's cool. And I was just disappointed that it just came up as weather for Merritt Island. But there's a little icon there. That's the good stuff. So let's take a look here. I'm going to click on the card. I'm going to scroll down to weather. Open this up. All right. And it looks like weather for Merritt Island. Can't click there. You have to click here. And then weather history for Merritt Island. Click the icon again. And we have a choice of either daily, weekly, or monthly. So I choose daily and say extract daily to the grid. All right, now I have 365 weather items. Let's see what we have there. Maybe 366. Let's see if they have February 29th. Of course, they'd have to have February 29th. Yep, so 366. So we come over here and say equal that dot, and we can get the max. That's the record high, or the min. That's the record low. Probably what makes more sense is the mean minimum temperature. So this is the low and the mean maximum temperature. Cool, this is the high. And do we have to double click to copy that down? No, just change B5 to B5 hash. That says give me the whole array that we get back. And same thing here, B5 to B5 hash. It's really weird that edit seems to be a little bit too far to the left. I can't explain that. The hassle, of course, I'm sitting here in Merritt Island, and I know it never gets down to 15 degrees, at least not what I call degrees. That is Celsius, because Wolfram Alpha is a scientific knowledge base. So, of course, they're going to use Celsius. So let's see, a couple things we want to do here. If I would want to chart this, I would want to add the date. So we come out here and do this dot day. And it's text. Oh my gosh, what the heck were they thinking? And so I asked for the date value of January 1st. Ah, that works. That gives me January 1st of this year. And if I want all of those B5 hash, and it gives me the whole year, that's great. All right, that's good. And then my chart here, I'll call this low and high. And so equal convert, that great old function from the analysis tool pack. I'm going to convert that data, which is in Celsius, to Fahrenheit. Beautiful. All right, same thing here, C5 hash. No deal. Hey, Joe McDade and the calc team, bet you thought no one would ever have to use convert on a 366 cells, but we never did, but now we do. So. This is one that I want to have to copy down. I don't think I can double click to copy it down. Oh, yeah, that works great. And then same thing here. Actually, I should just be able to copy it right across, right? Yeah, there we are. And double click and copy that down. And I choose all of that data. Control backspace to come back up to the top and insert a nice little line chart showing the two lines like that. So there's our high and low for every day of the year. Now, this is working for Merritt Island. Let's change it to somewhere else. So I'll come up here, Anchorage, Alaska. It resolves that, and then we get the hash busy. Well, it's downloading all of that data, and there we are. So now Anchorage a lot colder than Merritt Island. Weather data. When the new data types came out, stocks and geography, I was doing Excel seminars, I'd always say, well, what would you like to see next? And exchange rates was number one, which they've added. And then weather was number two. Hooray. They've added it. It's just awesome. Here's another one. All right. So remember, weather is available daily, weekly, or monthly. And so if we look at equal today, and then equal week num or ISO week num of today, that tells us that we're in week 33. So I have a series of cities here. And when I asked for the weekly data, of course, I got 53 weeks going down. But then check this out. What I did is I said, I want the index of A5.weather.history.weekly. And which one do I want? I hard-coded it to 38, but it'd make a lot more sense to use this current week. Double-click and copy that down. Dollar signs. jeez. That confused me. All right, so now we have week 33 weather weekly for all of these cities. Let's say we had stores in these cities, and we're trying to figure out, you know, are we going to advertise? What are we going to advertise next week or the week after? We're going to start to sell fall jackets. Well, only in the places where it's getting down in the 50s is that going to be appropriate. All right, so this is all cities pulling out 1 week. How am I doing that? The index of a5.weather.history.weekly, comma, 33. Next week, this changes to 34, 35, 36. If I want to plan 4 weeks ahead of time, just change that to +4, and the data updates. Weather data in Excel, this is so cool. These new Wolfram Alpha data types. You have to be on a home or student subscription right now. So, you know, I've been podcasting from this old laptop where I managed to get a home edition. They are so, so cool. And I realize I've just been going on and on and on, several videos in a row now. Well, that's just how cool they are. There we are.
All right, I love that weather data. If you like this video, please down below click like, subscribe, and ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the YouTube comments below. My new book, Mr. Excel 2020, Seeing Excel Clearly, that eye in the top right-hand corner will get you more information about that book. Finally, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.
Tips and tricks, get your spreadsheet fixed at MrExcel.com.